everybody! This is Agent Kak. Fire up the robot engines, because it's time to go full on forward into another part of the recap. So, here we go! So, these Zootadin beasts are going down pretty easily. Maybe a bit too easily. Oh well, maybe I'm just getting better. Okay, with the first wave of the Adams crush, I'm ready for more.
Zombie soldiers. Zombies. Zombies! Seriously, game? Seriously, game? Seriously, game? Seriously? Zombies?
Well, I never saw this coming. These zombies are apparently from a new villain group, the Death Army. The name makes sense. Well, at least they aren't too much stronger than the other foes we've been facing off against in the past few battles. But it's just the idea of zombies that still confuses me.
Zombies. In a game. About giant robots. I don't know either.
Maybe this has to do with an upcoming plot thread. Or something. Okay! The Dan Cougar is awesome.
Aggressive beast charge? What? Is it like some Power Ranger Megazord, like Team Mecha?
I'll just have to say yes to that. Okay, the final zombies are just about to fall. Time to end this scenario. Round 3? I was not expecting a round 3. But the crew of the Dan Cougar was apparently. And finally something I do know something about.
Wait, Domon! I know who that guy is! I know him! I know that Gundam! It had like, shining fingers! I remember Shining Finger!
Okay then! Three more zombies and the Devil Gundam! This should be quite easy!
Will he say his catchphrase? This hand of mine glows with our power! Its brain grip tells me to defeat you! This is the end! Shining Finger Sword! Go to hell! What? The... Fuck Nuggets! 40,000?
Or not. So, after a misunderstanding about what this game defines as saving, I am on a slightly better footing for the fight.
But shit.
Or not. Luckily, with some luck manipulation, I managed to survive the round.
For just this once, I'm going to save Scum my ass off.
Send it in the disco! Stat! Okay, good. Now that Domon is safe inside, we can start to focus on taking down the Devil Gundam, who just might be the absolute toughest opponent I have faced yet.
Hell yeah. Ouch, that hit super duper hard. This is the first really, really, really tough opponent I fought in this game.
At least he doesn't avoid every attack. Since he has enough HP, he doesn't really have the need to.
Tio.
Did I mention he hits hard?
Whoosh. Hell yeah. And he's all casually like, fire. Shit Domon.
Because he does. So I try to stay out of range and use weapons he can't fight back against, even if it means hitting a comrade.
I'm gonna do it anyway. Oh, good. 26% chance of hitting the other guy. Big ass gravity blast!
So, Domo is in critical condition yet again. Luckily, three people know trust, so Domo isn't 100% screwed. And with an attack from the Couchwell, the Devil Gundam is finally in the yellow range. I need to get the Devil Gundam's health below 40-80 to win, so I'm just about there. So the Devil Gundam is quite the douche, right? Right. So it would be even more annoying if he slightly healed between rounds, right? Right. Well, you know what? He does.
Okay, let's... Okay, let's just go with it.
I wonder why I didn't notice this in-game. Yeah, it takes me a while to figure that out. Well, later missions are only gonna get tougher. And once again, Domon is right at the doorstep of death. So, the health of the Devil Gundam is ticking down.
Yeah, good job, babe!
And down. And down.
Come on, Angie. You can do it. 1600.
And I'm out of troops. All seems lost. And then I'm greeted with the best surprise.
A Kato!
Finally, the battle is over. Or not. Luckily, the Devil Gundam retreats.
Wait, Domo's gonna try peace talk. Okay, good.
Domo wants to go after it, but his girlfriend, Rain, tells him Shining is too weak to do so, and she wants to team up with all the other robots in the area, because maybe they'll be able to help out. Although Domon really doesn't want to, he eventually gives in. So, as expected, the crew of the Dan Cougar wants to join the Nadesco too. After a bit of backstory is told about G Gundam, mostly about how the Devil Gundam came to be. And, on the plus side, Flay is once again on speaking terms with Kira again. Maybe something more, too. Wink, wink. She loves him! So, the Archangel plans on someday returning to Alaska and seeing how it goes there. So, the plan is for the Nadesco to be heading off for the Mediterranean Sea to lure Zafterway while the Archangel heads for the Indian Ocean. And it's up to Toya to choose what ship he wants to follow.
There's a split path?
Okay, everybody, this seems like a good stopping point for today. So, until the next part of the recap, this is Agent Kak, and I am saying adios.